Que me gusta verle su honestidad, ¿sabes? Que es un tipo que, no sé, mano, que él es él, tú sabes. Él no trata de oh, mira, vamos a ver si cambiamos un poquito para ver si puedo tener un hit. Vamos a, déjame ver, a ver si le, si le gusto a todos los sectores posibles de, tú sabes, del público. No, él simplemente dice lo que piensa y su honestidad en su música es increíble. Y John Lennon, me identifico más con él. Y siempre me llamó la atención cuando yo era un muñequito, siempre me gustaba que John era como que el smart guy. He was a smart guy. He was like the guy that says, okay, let's do this, guys. You know, that's what I like about John Lennon. So I identify myself with John Lennon.
Wow, yo, difícil. Me gustaría con John Lennon, decir John Lennon, porque John Lennon tiene la personalidad más rough, pero yo creo que la personalidad que más se identifica conmigo es la de George Harrison. George Harrison, musicalmente George Harrison hace las armonías de los Beatles, hace esos arreglos con las guitarras, también melodioso, y ese es más o menos mi approach también con la música. Y en lo personal, como George le dice en Quiet Beatles, yo también soy un poco callado y también al igual que George me gusta la introspección, tengo un jardín que siembro al igual que George, me gusta la música hindúa y la filosofía que George creía y muchas otras filosofías de otros países, las leo y me las vacilo, tú sabes. Así que George Harrison, that's my answer. ¿Y tú, Alejandro?
Yeah, yo estuve este ratito tratando de pensar una contestación fácil a esto, pero no se me ocurre. Así que tengo una contestación y me identifico con Paul y es porque quiero ser el lindo del grupo.
Great answer, Rand. Great answer.
Frank, ¿qué tú crees?
Pero fíjate, yo creo que tú eres el lindo del grupo ya.
Okay, wait. So, Alejandro, you want to be, you identify yourself with Paul McCartney because you want to be the cute
Want
guy
Muy bien. That's nice.
band? Frank, do you want to be the cute guy?
No, no, that's Alejandro is a cute guy, definitely. You know, I like things about all of them. You know, I don't know if I identify with just one. I mean, I like George Harrison a lot. He was a fellow Pisces. I like John Honesty. I like the fact that Paul is a workaholic. He's the one that always wants to work, which I like a lot. And I like Ringo's easygoing ways and sense of humor. So, this, I mean, I don't know. Hard to pick just one.
All right. Frank siempre es la persona diplomática, ¿verdad? Nunca hace.
No, yo creo que Frank es como Ringo. Frank es graciosito. No lo
Likeable.
aparenta, pero
It's
es bien
likeable by
graciosito.
everyone. Yeah. Bueno, vamos para la próxima pregunta. Vamos a ver, Mr. F, send us the graphic so we can see. Next question. All right, Generé asks, si pudieran ir atrás en el tiempo y ver un concierto de los Beatles, ¿cuál sería? If you could go back in time to one Beatles show, which one would it be? My pick would be the Beatles at the Washington Coliseum in February 1964. That is my favorite. I don't get tired of watching that show, man. I watch it over and over again because the Beatles were on fire. They just had a massive hit. When I Want to Hold Your Hand was number one in the hit, was number one. The album Meet the Beatles was number one. They just did the Ed Sullivan Show. They were on fire, man. Estaban pompeados los Beatles. Y cuando ellos fueron y hicieron su primer concierto en Estados Unidos, fue ese, Washington Coliseum. Y fue una cosa apoteósica de que, man, they were on fire. I love that show.
That's a good choice, man. That's a good choice.
Yeah.
But if you ask me, I would pick to go to see the Beatles at the Cavern Club because when they started playing famously, their shows are half hour, right? Half hour shows. So in the Cavern, maybe I would get a chance to see them longer, for an hour maybe, 2 hours. Ahí. Me gustaría, si pudiera darle la vuelta al tiempo, definitivamente quisiera ir al último show de los Beatles en The Cavern.
Cavern Club. Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good choice. Ale.
Yo escogería, yo creo que está difícil. Yo iba a decir Washington, pero por el sake de decir otro.
Hay unos cuantos. There's many shows. The Beatles didn't have a long time touring, but the shows that they did were memorable. Yeah. Were historic.
Yeah. Yo creo que el que yo escogería ver es Shea Stadium. Por el hecho de que ellos llegan así caminando por el parque y todo el mundo muriéndose porque ellos ahí, que cuando ellos llegan en la guagua esta de super grande para protegerlos y toda esta película que ellos logran, ¿verdad? Y ese como que el momento de este estadio gigante, este small stage en el mismo medio, eso para mí es grande. Eso para mí es, yo creo que es el biggest concert para mí.
Yeah, Shea Stadium was the biggest concert at the time, 56,000 people, and it held that record for a long time.
Yeah.
And, you know, there was no internet, there was no social media. It was just people that wanted to see the Beatles. Shea Stadium was historic.
Mm-hmm.
Good choice, man. Good choice.
Toronto.
I was going to say the Cavern. it's a place where you could actually hear them. So to say something different, I'm gonna go with the rooftop concert.
Oh,
it's the third one, but you know, if you happen to be at the rooftop or on the street down below, you could actually listen to them, because in Shea Stadium, what you hear are the screams, and you know, in most of the concerts here in Washington, you probably would only hear the screams. So, yeah, Treasure is Cavern, but you know, to say something different than the rooftop.
Mano, rooftop es un good choice.
Oh,
wow. Yeah,
that's a great choice. Great choice, man.
Because you know, it was great because nobody knew that the Beatles were going to break up at that time. You know, so it was like, oh man, the Beatles, would they go back to tour? Would they, sabes, volverán a tocar otra vez en vivo? Mm-hmm. And the buzz, you know, they created that buzz, and it never happened. You know, as history says.
Anyway.
Yeah, así que. Piso, ponme la otra gráfica. We still have one more question.
Hey,
watch out, man. Okay, Cristina, she asked, si cada uno de ustedes pudiera escoger una sola guitarra para tocar las canciones de los Beatles, ¿cuál sería y por qué? If each one of you could only choose one guitar to play all the Beatles tunes, which guitar would it be and why? Well, this is a technical question, you know, aimed at musicians. I'm not a guitar player, but I would choose the Casino. The Epiphone Casino, I think it's my favorite, you know, of all the Beatles guitars. You know, it has that warm sound, that deep sound. And, yeah, that's the one, Casino. The day started using it in 1966.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Esa es la Casino. Esa es la que yo call.
All right.
Exactamente. Pues yo. Yo me iría, I would go over to the bass playing. I would love to be playing the Hofner bass that Paul McCartney used. If I had a choice forever in my life, that would be it, man. I would be Paul in this band, but Alejandro is much better.
You want to be the cute one?
I want to be the cute one, but Alejandro is much cuter.
Man.
Oh, man. Ale, ¿qué tú piensas?
Bueno, pues yo voy a coger la Rickenbacker de John Lennon, la Black Rickenbacker. Para mí esa siempre ha sido, yo creo que desde que empecé a escuchar los Beatles, esa guitarra fue para mí como un emblema, como un logo en lo que eran los Beatles y esa pose que John Lennon toma va a la par con la guitarra. So para mí la guitarra es ese emblema, ¿verdad? Además del Hofner Lefty, pues esa guitarra de John es el toque para mí.
Qué cool que cambiamos los instrumentos.
Cambiamos. Maybe someday.
dale.
Claro. It's harder for George Harrison because, you know, he has the signature sounds, the 12-string Rickenbacker, the Gretsch, the Ed Sullivan Gretsch, and the Rocky. If I had to pick just one, I would go with this one.
Boom.
It's my favorite. This is the one that everybody asks me the most about, so Defender not, Rough Draft.
Not fair, de todo el mundo, Frank es el único que dice, yo quiero tocar esta.
Yeah. All right, guys, vamos a leer algunos de los comentarios del público. Let's you know, since we're in the answering question mood, vamos a ver algunos de los comentarios del público, ¿verdad? A ver qué nos pueden decir.
Let's do it. Mm-hmm.
Que búscate algo por ahí.
A ver, en Facebook, X Level PR Media. Vamos a ver qué dice aquí.
Hola, saludos a Luis Torres, que se está conectando ahora mismo en xlevelpr.com. Saludos a Laurie Barber, Aidan, que siempre se conecta con nosotros en todos nuestros shows. Todo esto es a través de la página de xlevelpr.com. That's where we're, you know, transmitting now. We're also doing this on Facebook. Let me see if I can see. Miren a ver algún comentario ustedes. Chequen ahí.
Wow, estoy aquí buscando porque...
Mira, aquí Luis Torres dijo que otro bajo significativo así de Paul es el de Something.
¿Cuál es ese?
El de Something, el de...
La línea de bajo.
En especial, ¿verdad? En el coro y el verso. Que... Así que estoy contigo, Luis. Estoy contigo.
Oye, tú sabes que le preguntaron a George Harrison about Paul bass playing on that song, and he said, "Well, you know, he overdid it. He played too much, but you know, I guess it worked."
I guess.
Esa era tiradera.
Well, eso fue un overplaying very, very tasteful. Así que realmente yo no puedo criticar ese bajo.
No.
Para mí es perfecto para la canción.
Sí,
super.
Judith Strandberg, thank you for joining the party. Judith Strandberg nos dice aquí. Ay, dice, I just saw myself in there. Yes, you are.
Cool. Saludito también. We want to say hi to Anna Gall, Flo. Yeah.
Thank you, Justin.
Thank you for the gracias fabulous birthday wishes. Christine Park. This is Brooke. She always with us, you know, Lynn also, and Tammy. Yeah, man, thank you for being with us tonight.
Yes, we love you all.
Yeah, I think it's time for, you know, for...
For what?
Wait, I was looking at this. No, I just want to say, you know, I can't stress this enough. Support your local musicians. You know, if you guys know a musician or a band, I'm sure you know. Estoy seguro que ustedes conocen bandas. Este es el momento de apoyar las bandas, que ahora mismo no hay conciertos en vivo, así que háganlo. Yo sé que todo el mundo está más o menos en el mismo bote, ¿verdad? Pero vamos a apoyar las bandas, vamos a comprar su CD, vamos a comprar su música, let's download their music, let's buy their t-shirts, you know, whatever merchandising they have, let's help out the local musicians. You know, everybody's doing Facebook Lives, everybody's, you know, doing the most out of the situation. So, you know, we want you to help out and contribute, and if you don't want to help us, you know, contribute for us to keep doing the show, you know, during all this, you know, this very stressful time, you know, you can send your contribution to our PayPal link, stukebox_beatles@yahoo.com. I mean, I know it's a tough time for everyone, but, you know, if you can do it, we'll be more than grateful, you know.
We'll be grateful, yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Support your local musicians.
Hey, something that I want to say about supporting the musicians. A few people have asked, and streaming the music from Spotify or iTunes or something like that, it doesn't actually help musicians. You have to digitally buy the songs or the albums, or watch the videos. On their YouTube page, on their personal YouTube page, because that's actually supporting them. If you stream the music on iTunes or any other thing, you know, like Spotify or Pandora, that actually helps that company to earn money. So
actually, if you download it, like for example, say Apple Music, if you download the CD, then you're helping.
Yeah, exactly.
But if you stream it, then not really.
Yeah, because what you get is like a fraction of a fraction of a fraction of a cent.
Of
right?
A cent, yeah.
Que .00001 de un centavo por cada streaming, tú sabes.
Yeah, it's not even a cent for a player.
Exacto. Exacto, y uno que piensa que está auspiciando al artista que uno tanto ama o que le gusta, que se disfruta mucho. Y está auspiciando a un montón de gente que no tiene nada que ver con el artista. Así que sí, todo de esta manera, de estas formas nuevas que están creándose ahora por esto del coronavirus, pues entonces cada persona puede ser un auspiciador de su banda favorita dentro de lo poco, tú sabes.
Claro. Porque claro que sí, claro que sí. Yes, so, sir. Thank you to all who have contributed so far. Thank you very much. You know, we're keeping this show alive so we can come back every Tuesday and do the show, you know, and have a little bit of fun because that's what we're doing. Estamos teniendo un poquito de diversión y esparcimiento en estos momentos tan estrésicos, en buen español, ¿verdad? So, So connect with us, you know, go to our social links, social media links on Facebook. We're the Jukebox Beatles. We're on Facebook. Look for this logo, Jukebox Beatles Tribute on Facebook. Twitter también, the Jukebox PR. Instagram, Jukebox Beatles Tribute, and LinkedIn.com/IN/TheJukebox. So look for that logo. That's the official logo. Don't accept, you know, anything less than that.
Copycats.
Guys, man, estamos ya casi terminando el show. We're almost to the end. So, no. Pero vamos a aprovechar la ocasión. You know, we have our technical director, nuestro director técnico se llama Fisu. Nosotros le decimos Mr. F. Mr. F is a guy that you listen to, that you can hear him, but you never see him. He's like Charlie from the Charlie's Angels. Now, here's a picture of Mr. F.
Wow,
eso
es
you still can see him.
¿Qué estará?
Eso es una gran máscara.
That's great,
Mr. F, man.
¿Cómo se encuentra?
We still can't see his face.
¿Cómo se encuentra mis ángeles?
Dressed up like in Halloween like that.
He should.
So thank you, Mr. F, for all the work. You know, él está bregando aquí con las cuestiones técnicas. He's the guy behind, you know, the cameras and, you know, the sound and everything. The internet connection is doing the best, you know, under the circumstances. And it's been a challenge for Mr. F, but le agradecemos todo el trabajo, right?
Sí, gracias.
So guys, this is it. This wraps it up. Another edition of Beatlemania XL. Tenemos que irnos ya. Y ahora de irnos. Así que muchas gracias por su sintonía. Todos los que nos vieron en Facebook, que nos vieron a través de la página de xlevelpr.com, todos los que nos vieron a través de Roku. Thank you very much. You know, thank you very much. It's always a pleasure, and we love doing this. So we expect to see you next Tuesday. Arle, any final words?
Sí, sí. Que sigan sintonizando este canal, xlevelpr.com, que se pasan dando películas super chéveres a las 7 de la noche. El otro día están dando la película 1917. Están dando Sonic. Así que estén pendientes. Este canal está bien chévere.
X-Level. Cool movies. Yeah. Ale.
Gracias a todo el mundo por sintonizar nuevamente, ¿verdad? Nosotros estamos aquí todos los martes and we're going to keep doing this if you guys are here. Así que thanks to you guys, we're doing this, y gracias por darnos algo en qué buscar en esta cuarentena tan horrible. Así que we love you all, mano. Gracias por darnos un poquito de esperanza, un poquito de ese output. Y hopefully it was enjoyable for you guys too. Así que see you next week.
Muy bien, esperanza. Me gusta esa palabra.
So yeah, I want to say thanks to everybody for tuning in and for those that contributed to us. Thank you very much. It's always fun. You know, we miss playing outside. Everybody keep safe. Take the precautions. And, you know, we'll get through this eventually. So rock on.
Yeah, muchas gracias, guys. We'll see you next Tuesday. a las 9 de la noche a través de xlevelpr.com. Muchas gracias por su sintonía. We'll see you guys next week. We love you. We're the Jukebox Beatles. And let's take it home. Obla ti, brother.
Obla.
Yes.